Remain standing. Let us sing hymn number 365. Hymn number 365. Remain standing. Let us follow the order of service. Let us pray. Almighty God, unto whom all hearts be open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hid, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of thy Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love thee and worthily magnify thy holy name, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Our Lord Jesus Christ said, Hear, O Israel, the Lord our God is one Lord, and thou shalt love the Lord thy God with all thy heart, with all thy soul, with all thy mind, and with all thy strength. This is the first commandment, And the second is like it, namely this: thou shalt love thy neighbor as thyself. There is none other commandment greater than these. On these two commandments hang all the law and the prophets. Lord, have mercy upon us and write all these thy laws in our hearts, we beseech thee. Collect for the day: unity for justice and peace. Let us pray. God of peace and justice, who sent your Son Jesus Christ, the Prince of Christ, for our redemption, empower us with the spirit of justice to have right judgments in all things and in establishing a peaceful kingdom, and await the coming judge through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Please be seated. Let us hear the scripture readings.
I will take the children of Israel from among the heathen whither they go be gone, and will gather them on every side and bring them unto their own land. And I will make them one nation in the land upon the mountains of Israel, and one king shall be king to them all. And there shall be no more two nations, neither shall they be divided into two kingdoms any more at all. Neither shall they defile themselves any more with their idols, nor with their detestable things, nor with any of their transgressions. But I will say unto them how, of all their dwelling places wherein they have sinned, and will cleanse them, so shall they be my people, and I will be their God. And David my servant shall be king over them, and they shall all have one shepherd. They shall also walk in my judgments and observe my statutes and do them. And they shall do
remain standing. Let us profess our faith through Nicene Creed. Let us say together:
thank you.
obedience of God as we are meditating upon your word. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Please be seated. Dear friends, I greet you all in the name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. By the grace of God, we are in the fourth Sunday of this year. Still, we have something different to say about the pandemic situation. Still, we have SOP to follow in our gathering. But at the same time, we the people are very conscious about our own involvement in worshipping Lord Jesus. Next week will be the last Sunday of this first month of 2021. Day after tomorrow, we will be giving importance to our Republic Day. We will have our own celebration as we are the citizen of this country. In this context, we have a special theme for our meditation. The theme for today's meditation is Unity for Justice and Peace. We have our own tradition. In that, we give much importance to our own church tradition. There are different kinds of tradition as we are involving in different attitude and we are making ourselves available to different groups. The theme for today's meditation is Unity for Justice and Peace. We should be united with the foundation, with the basic knowledge of justice and ill treatment from his own brothers. But he was known for his own purity. He gave much importance to God. His own blood, his own brothers made him to be out of the relationship. They were least bothered about Joseph. They were very particular of their own name and fame in the family. They want to eliminate Joseph. They had a plan. They sold him out to a group of people, business people. But he experienced, because of his own blood, because of his own brother, he was in a pit. In the pit also, he was so confident because he is known for his own involvement according to the values of God. That is what his own understanding. He was in a pit, but after some time, he had a different kind of life, different style of living. God has given something different to him, but again, he had something crucial in his own life. From pit to, he moved to prison. He was in the pit. After some time, he was in the prison, but he was known for his own understanding of God. He gave much importance to God alone. He never worried about his own brothers. He never worried about his own relationship, but he was very much interested in the relationship of God alone. Today, we need to give much importance to our own relationship with our Creator. He was the one who created us. He was the one who gives everything to us. Joseph gave much importance to God. He was in the pit because of his own brothers. He was in the prison for his own godly involvement in the society. Because of his own purity, he was sent to the prison. He was in the pit, he was in the prison. But the ultimate thing is something unique. He had his own elevation in his own life. Pit, prison, then palace. Palace was waiting for him. Today, in our life, if we are giving importance to God in our own priority, we will maintain purity in our own heart. There should not be any hidden agenda. The brothers of Joseph had hidden agenda. They were very particular of making him to be out in the family. Because of that, they gave him a gift, a pit. Then he experienced his own life in the prison. But there, God intervenes. If you are giving importance to God as your own priority of your own living in this world, and if you are maintaining purity, you will have such an elevation. You will have such a shift. Today, we need to think about our own understanding of God. Then only we can have peace and justice, which we can enjoy in our life. On the other side, in the Old Testament, we see the young man Daniel. He openly declares, I will worship only God. I will never give importance to my own fellow human being, fellow Christians, fellow brothers and sisters, but I will worship only God. I will give respect, I will honor my own brothers and sisters, but I will never worship anyone, even the king. In those days, there was an understanding. King is the reflection of God. That is what the understanding of the people. So people should worship king. But here, the young man Daniel, he was very courageous, very brave enough. He says, I will worship only God. He is the living God. Whether he gives something different to me or I am not getting it, I will worship only God. Today, we should have such a purity of our own understanding. We should have such a empathy in our own involvement of understanding God. By that, we can have justice and peace in our own lives. So purity is very much important. That is what the quality of a disciple. If you want to be the disciple of Lord Jesus, you should have such a discipline. If you are not having such a discipline, you cannot be a disciple of Lord Jesus. So priority, purity. The third and important point is something different, that is prosperity. We people are longing for our own prosperous life. In our Christian community, we people are going here and there to get miracles in our own life. There we can have different kind of attraction in the name of Lord, in the name of Word of God. They attract people. That is why we are going there. By making ourselves available in that assembly or meeting, we are making ourselves available to the illusionary world. We are giving importance to illusion. We are giving much importance to emotion. But here is the truth. We need to give much importance to priority, purity. Then you will have prosperity. If you happen to read what is purity in the biblical Bible dictionary, that one author says, purity is the quality of being faultless, uncompromised, and unadulterated. Uncompromised is the policy of Lord Jesus. Sometimes we have our own downfall. We have our own fall in our own life because we are compromising everything. We are not giving importance to justice. We are not giving importance to peace of God. Our Lord is so particular of establishing justice and peace in this society. That is what the values of the kingdom of God. In our society, we need to have such an understanding. That is the comprehensive understanding. That is what our total involvement in Christianity. That is what our own reflection of accepting Lord Jesus as our own Savior, as our own leader, being a disciple. We should not have a policy of compromising. If Lord Jesus could have had the compromising policy, we would have not been here. There was no cross in the history of Christianity, but he never compromised anything. He was so particular. He was very specific. He was very special in his own expression of making things according to the values of God. He treated everyone equal. He gave much importance to equality. He wants everything to be right, everything to be disciplined. Because of that, he had suffering. He had cross. If he compromised, there will not be a word cross in the dictionary of Christianity. Today, you are very particular of getting prosperity in your own life. To attain such a thing in your own life, you should give much importance to your own priority and purity. Then only you will get prosperity. See, Joseph had pit. Joseph was in prison, but the ultimate thing is different. The ultimatum is in the hands of God. No one can take it off. He is almighty. He is known for his own power. He is known for his own execution. Instead of not giving importance to priority and purity, we are very particular of getting prosperity. In what way we can get? In the Sermon on the Mount, Lord Jesus was so particular of expositing. You should give much importance to the word of God. You should give much importance to the kingdom values. Then only you will have added blessing in your own life. That is the first thing. That should be your priority. Then only you can have everything. In our epistle reading, Paul says, I can do all things through him who strengthens me. People used to have their own escapism. You can see the attitude in the lifestyle of Lord's disciples. When they had some challenge, when they had something different, they never had involvement. They compromised everything. By that, they had their own fall. But Lord never compromised anything. He acted upon the values of the kingdom of his own Father. Today, we need to think about our own priority and purity. Then we will have prosperity in our own life. In our society, there was a professor. Still, she works at SIET College in Nandanam. She was a well-known orator, teacher, well-known person in the society. She was invited to a coloring competition in a nearby school. In that, 24 candidates were involving in that coloring competition. All were deaf and dumb. The professor was very much interested to see the people's involvement in that competition. After the competition, the principal of that school gave all the papers to that professor to judge the results. After spending much time, he has selected 3 candidates as number 1, number 2 and 3. After some time, the prizes were distributed to the students. When she was getting down from the stage, there was a small boy. Met the professor and he asked the professor, where is my prize? Where is my prize? This is what the small boy asked such a well-known professor in the society. She was thrilled by that question. She was in a different situation. She was not in a position to answer to that little boy. Then he said, you are not qualified to receive prize. Immediately the boy said, ma'am, this is coloring competition. He said, this is coloring competition. Then the professor was so confident. I went through all the papers of the 24 candidates. So I was very careful in selecting the first, second and third. So I will give all the 24 papers to that small little boy. He gave the bunch of 24 papers to that boy. By seeing that bunch of 24 papers, he touched only one paper in that pack. He snatched that paper from that group of candidates' paper. Immediately, he has shown that paper to that professor. This is my picture. The professor was so happy. God made me to do justice to these people. What is this? By seeing the paper, the professor said, everything is black and there is a route in that something is red. She thought this fellow is reflecting about the party of Tamil Nadu. There are flags in our Tamil Nadu. People are giving importance to that. So he is very particular about that flag. So he explicited such a thing in coloring. Then the professor asked that little boy, what is your explanation about this? There is very black thing and a small round. In that there is reddish in color. He said, this is the sky, this is the moon. This is what that boy said to that educated, eminent professor of this society. Let me want to get your explanation. She was very particular. He was not worthy to receive prize. There are other pictures. It was so clear. Then he said, what is the competition? The little boy said, the competition is coloring, coloring competition. Then only the professor got the point. This is not drawing competition. This is coloring competition. Then what is your explanation? The little boy said, this is the sky, this is the moon. Then the professor asked, what is the color of the sky? The little boy said, blue. What is the color of the moon? He said, off-white. When we are receiving such a question in our life, what we will say? White we used to say. But there was a boy who is very deaf and dumb. But he reflected and said the appropriate word, off-white. The professor was little bit worried. He said, sky is blue, moon is off-white. Then, what is this? She had a different kind of reflection with that little boy. He said, because of her own attitude, the sky is angry. That is why it looks black. That black is reflected in the off-white moon. Because of that, it has become reddish in expression. Then only the professor got the point. This is not drawing competition. This is coloring competition. In that coloring, he reflects because of human beings, because of humanity, because of the different kind of involvement. The blue sky has become black in expression. We are making everything in a different way. We are not eco-friendly. We are not giving importance to ecology. This is what the reflection of that little boy. Then she made something different to that little boy. She gave much importance to that little boy. She gave prize from her own packet. Today, we should have such an understanding. Without understanding biblical teachings, without understanding the scripture in an appropriate way, we will never explicit comprehensive understanding of peace and justice. There are people, they are making their own justice. We should not have such a thing in our own life. Justice should be according to the values of the kingdom of God. You should have priority, you should have purity, then you will have prosperity. May God bless these verses. Amen. Let us pray. Our loving and gracious Father, Lord, help us and guide us to have comprehensive understanding of your justice and peace, and help us to enjoy the same in our own day-to-day life. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Members who are celebrating their birthdays in this week: Mrs. Alexa Caroline Bernard, Master Jeril Calvin Jaykumar, Mrs. Daisy Iona Matthew, Master Andrew Joel Jacob, Mrs. Epsiba Joseph. Couples who are celebrating their wedding anniversaries in this week: Mrs. and Mr. Brian and Audrey Erft, Mrs. and Mr. John Verghese Matthew, Mrs. and Mr. Ronald Kenneth Joel. Let us pray for the members who are celebrating their birthdays and wedding anniversaries in this week. Let us pray. Our loving and gracious Father, we pray for our members who are celebrating their birthdays and wedding anniversaries in this week. Please bless our members and guide them in their new year. Dear Lord, please protect and guide them as they continue along the path we have chosen for them. Give them the courage to follow in your light and feel your love wherever they go. Make them strong and give them the strength to make good decisions, resolutions in this new year. Keep them free from illness and sadness, for they are truly good persons who deserve happiness, success and justice in all aspects of life. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Let us rise up and sing hymn number 307. While we are singing, we will offer our offertory. Hymn number 307. Thank you. Let us follow the order of service. Let us pray. Let us pray for the whole state of Christ Church militant here on earth. Almighty and ever-living God, who by thy holy apostle has taught us to make prayers and supplications and to give thanks for all men, we humbly beseech thee to accept our alms and oblations and to receive these our prayers which we offer. Inspire continually the universal church with the spirit of truth, unity and concord, and that all who confess the holy name may agree in the truth of thy holy word and live in unity and godly love. We beseech thee to lead all nations in the way of righteousness and peace, and so guide their rulers that thy people may be justly and quietly governed. We especially remember our president, the prime minister, the governor of the state, and all in authority under them. Give grace, O heavenly Father, to all bishops, priests, and deacons, that by their life and doctrine they may set forth thy true and life-giving word, and rightly and duly administer thy holy sacraments, and to all thy people give thy heavenly grace. Grant that this congregation may hear and receive thy holy word, and truly serve thee in holiness and righteousness all the days of their life. And we most humbly beseech thee of thy goodness, O Lord, to comfort and secure all who are in trouble, sorrow, need, sickness, or any other adversity. And we also bless thy holy name for all thy servants departed this life in thy faith and fear. Give us grace so to follow their good examples, that with them we may be partakers of thy heavenly kingdom. Grant this, O Father, for Jesus Christ's sake, our only mediator and advocate. Amen. You that do truly and earnestly repent of your sins and are in love and charity with your neighbors and intend to lead a new life following the commandments of God and walking from henceforth in his holy ways, draw near with faith and take this holy sacrament to your comfort, and make your humble confession to Almighty God, meekly kneeling upon your knees. Let us confess our sins to our Almighty Father by following the prayer found in the order of service. Let us say together, Almighty God, Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, maker of all things, judge of all men, we acknowledge and bewail our manifold sins and wickedness, which we from time to time most grievously have committed by thought, word, and deed, against thy divine majesty, provoking most justly thy wrath and indignation against us. We earnestly repent and are heartily sorry for this our misdoings. The remembrance of them is grievous unto us, the burden of them is intolerable. Have mercy upon us, most merciful Father, for thy the Son, our Lord Jesus Christ's sake, forgive us all that is past, and grant that we may ever hereafter serve and please thee in newness of life, to the honor and glory of thy name, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Almighty God, our heavenly Father, who of his great mercy has promised forgiveness of sins to all them that with hearty repentance and true faith turn unto him, have mercy upon you, pardon and deliver you from all your sins, confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and bring you to everlasting life, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Hear what the comfortable verses our Savior Christ saith unto all that truly turn to him. Come unto me, all that are heavy laden, and I will refresh you. God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, to the end that all that believe in him should not perish but have everlasting life. Here also what St. Paul saith, this is a true saying and worthy of all men to be received, that Christ Jesus came into the world to save sinners. Here also what St. John saith, if any man sin, we have an advocate with the Father, Jesus Christ the righteous, and he is the propitiation for our sins. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks unto our Lord God. It is very meet, right, and our bounden duty that we should at all times and all places give thanks unto thee, O Lord, Holy Father, Almighty, Everlasting God. Therefore, with angels and archangels and with all the company of heaven, we loud and magnify the glorious name evermore, praising thee and saying, say together, we do not presume to come to this thy holy table, O merciful Lord, trusting in our own righteousness, but in thy manifold and great mercies. We are not worthy so much as to gather up the crumbs under thy table, but thou art the same Lord, whose property is always to have mercy. Grant us therefore, gracious Lord, so to eat the flesh of thy dear Son Jesus Christ and drink his blood, that our sinful bodies may be made clean by his body, and our souls washed through his most precious blood, and that we may evermore dwell in him and he is in us. Let us pray. Almighty and ever living God, we most heartily thank thee that thou dost vouchsafe to feed us with the spiritual food of the most precious body and blood of thy Son, our Savior Jesus Christ, and as assured as thereby of thy favor and goodness towards us, and that we are members incorporate in the mystical body of thy Son, which is the blessed company of all faithful people, and are also heirs through hope of thy everlasting kingdom by the merits of the most precious death and passion of thy dear Son. We most humbly beseech thee, O Heavenly Father, to assist us with thy grace, that we may continue in that holy fellowship and to do all such good works as thou hast prepared for us to walk in, through Jesus Christ our Lord, to whom with thee and the Holy Ghost be all honor and glory, world without end. Amen. Let us sing the Gloria together. Let us pray. Lord of heaven, we thank you for the blessings of life and health. Thank you for allowing us to have the opportunity to be in your presence again today. We come together with the unity of our faith and ask that everything be bound in heaven. Allow everything be loosed in heaven. Together we will compact the evil that gathers and asks that evil doers be confronted. May their plans always come to naught. Bless us so that we may leave here today with your spiritual blessings. Heavenly Father, Father God, we have come to the end of worship and we want to thank you for enabling us to be here from the beginning to the end. Thank you for teaching and touching our lives in ways we cannot explain. We have taken us to your realms of glory. We want to say thank you and we depart to our homes and various destinations. We ask you to continue being with us. Let your spirit see us through. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. The peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of His Son Jesus Christ our Lord, and the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost be among us you and remain with you always. Let us say together, bless the Lord, O my soul, all that is within me, bless His holy name. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and forget not all His benefits. The Lord be with you. Let us depart in peace in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.